Genesis Day 2. Last night, it was pretty difficult. It took about 10 minutes for him to go to bed. And overnight, he woke up once, and then I woke him up twice as well. This for potty breaks. He's telling you that he wants to go outside. This is the result. When he woke up, I did the same thing. It was a lot quicker since he's tired. Again, you just need to remind him that he needs to go to bed. As you can see, I have it opened. He's been sleeping here in his crate, you know, during the day. But yeah, it seems to be working. But you know, we'll see later when he wakes up for his potty break. If it's gonna be the same. Gotta be quiet. Oh, he woke up a little, but I should go back to bed. Let's leave the little guy. Okay, it's only been an hour. It's 10:30. So this is what happens when Fuji wakes up. You can probably hear it by now. But okay, he stopped. But yeah, so you know, as they say, you know, they can be pretty loud. It's like a T-Rex or a dinosaur for a small puppy. But hey, Fuji. So again, don't open the crate unless he's settled. You know, we don't want him to learn that his crying is a good thing. So a few things. If your puppy cries like this, could be a few things. Could be that he needs to go potty, so we need to hurry up and go outside, or he's thirsty, or he wanna. It could be any of those. So it could be he's fully awake now. He just wants to get out, or a potty break. One of those three is the reason why he's crying. Okay, so okay, I'll take him for his potty break, and I'll see you in a sec to put him back to bed. Ah, oh, come on, buddy, come on, back to bed. I know you're sleepy. Okay, Fuji, it's bedtime. Okay, so just quickly, I took him out for his potty break. He also had some water. Now, since he's a puppy, I still allowed him to drink past 9 p.m. You know, when he's a bit older, there won't be any drinks at 9 p.m. because that's just, you know, that's a recipe for disaster. He might have an accident because he won't be able to hold it that long. But since he's a puppy, he needs as much water as he needs. So I'll let him drink that. Okay. Well, as you can see, I think I don't need to do that. I don't need to do that thing anymore. He's asleep already. Okay, well, that was easy. Worked out quite well. Sorry, Fudge. Right. He'll wake up again in the middle of the night later. So I'll see you shortly. If he's not awake, I've got a timer to let him out. It's every 3 hours. So it's about 10:40, so let's say 11. I'll wake him up around 2 a.m., give him his potty break, and then straight back to bed. Okay? Alright, I'll see you later. Okay.
think 20 minutes to 2, Fuji woke up. So we're gonna take him out before he, he has an accident. I don't know if it can be seen. Hey Fuji. Come on. I know, buddy. I know. Okay, come on. Let's go. Stretch. As I said, it's almost 2 a.m. Just took him out for his potty break. But straight away he goes back to sleep. Oh, wow, poor Fuji. He's got a hiccup. Okay, buddy. But yeah, there's not much to crate training. All you need is the time and also the willpower. Waking up at this time isn't great, but you know, it's an investment for your puppy, your puppy's future. Also the same for you. You want them to be successful. You don't want any accidents in the house when they're, you know, an adult. So yeah, just doing this for, you know, a month, or you know, a month and a bit, or even less than a month, will give them the best start in life, you know. Okay, I'm gonna go back to bed. And Fuji's already back sleeping. Okay.